but preach the gospel, preach the death and the burial and the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, because Christ is able to save you from the guttermost to the uttermost. Clap your hands and pray. Come on, come on. No time. I gotta go for what I do. Turn your legs out. Hope you get out of here alive. Because you're gonna get out of here. Oh yeah. Everybody in the choir, you will get out of here. I know you sang good, but you get up out of here. You're gonna start singing one day. Am I right about it? And when you get out of here, I hope you get out of here alive. The Bible says that they beat Jesus and they pulled the flesh from the bone. He was marked like no other man. They beat him with rods. They pulled the flesh from his bones. They spit in his face. They put a crown of thorns on his head. And they whipped him and beat him. And beat him and whipped him. But he never said a word, because he had your sins and my sins and mine. Aren't you glad today that you can't save yourself? Savior, and I'm so glad that somebody told me about Jesus, and I'm so glad that I repented and accepted him as my Savior. Let me come down. Oh, devotion. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody kept here and said, thank you, Jesus. I'll have mercy. I gotta go. But isn't it wonderful to know this? To know that Jesus Christ, the Son of the true and living God, became sin for us who knew no sin, that the righteousness of God may be in us. When you accept Christ as your Savior, God puts your sins on Jesus and then puts his righteousness on you. And then you got to have sense enough to come on out of your sin. Too many folks making excuses for your sin. If you washed in the holy blood of Jesus, I said the holy blood of Jesus, if you're born of the Holy Ghost, and you're living out of the Holy Bible, you can't be nothing else but holy. Holy! Holy! You got people that sin before they judge. I say, don't be judging. We're going to judge you. Yes, we are too. We're going to judge angels. We're going to tell you still got sin in you. You need to repent. You still got sin in you. You need to get washed in the blood. And you hope to see God, keep your sins. Turn your neighbor and say, you hope to see God, keep your sins up. I got a close. I'm going to tell you right now, thank God for the power of the blood of Jesus, and thank God for the power of the Holy Ghost. But I'm telling you right now, I would need to thank and praise God for holiness.
Yay!
Thank God for sanctification.
Hallelujah!
Thank God for consecration. I'm saved and sanctified.
Yay!
Been saved all day. How evil have I done? I want to thank and praise God that you're looking at a sanctified preacher.
Amen.
I got a wife and no girlfriend.
Amen.
I'm living in Texas, California. Ain't got no boyfriend neither. And ask God to forgive you and get washed in the blood and read your Bible, fast and pray. Fast and pray and read your Bible. And today might be the day. You may not die today, but you may die tomorrow. If you don't die tomorrow, you may die next month, next year, next decade. But sure, baby, someday you're going to get out of here. And I hope you get out of here alive. Clap your hands and get out of here alive. Here's what I'm going to close with. Listen, listen. Turn your neighbor and say, don't lie, church. You ain't got to lie to them. Whatever you do, I'm going to go show. I feel the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
He said, ocean. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
I'm going to do something I know Sister Charlene is looking now. You know, sometimes you see them actors and entertainers. the person been married four or five times, and a he, she, and she, he, and they talking about they up there looking down. I be saying, no, they ain't, they down there looking it up, man of God. Everybody ain't going to heaven. Nothing but the righteous. I'm saved by grace. I said, this is what you're saying. Listen to what you're saying. You're saying you're saved by grace. Wait a minute now. If you're saved by grace, are you trying to tell me grace can't keep you? What you're talking about, you're saved by grace. As if the devil's power more powerful than grace. Ain't no devil in hell who walk through grace. Ain't no devil in hell who walk through the blood of Jesus. Oh yes, Sister Charlene Jackson was a great woman.
Beautiful woman.
I could call that house. Sometime I'd get in trouble and I'd leave Bob right there. Yeah. She never said you called too early. She never said you called too late. She was a sweet-hearted woman. Many times she, Bob and Osa and I had meals together. It was always a pleasant experience. She was not a sitter. She was not bougie.
All right.
I want every head to be bowed right now, every eye closed, in the choir, all down the aisles. Because I, just like Sister Charlene, I too have a concern about you getting out of here alive. If you don't accept Christ, you're going to get out of here dead. You're going to end up burning in hell. But if you come out of here alive, that means you come out of here born again, absent from the body. So the Lord's going to descend from heaven with a shout.
Amen.
The voice of the archangel. Trump of God. Dead in Christ shall rise first, and those of us who are alive and remain shall be caught up together in the cloud. To meet the Lord in there.
Amen.
So shall we ever be with the Lord. I don't know about you, but I'm looking forward to that day. That's why I'm doing all I can while I'm
here. Amen.
When he called my name, I don't want him to catch me out of sorts. I want him to catch me sanctified.
Amen.
Every head is bowed, every eyes closed. All right, now don't lie in the church now. How many of you don't say, I hope so, and I might be, and I don't know. But if you don't, if you're not absolutely sure, don't raise your hand. But how many of you in here today are absolutely sure if you died right now, you go to heaven and raise your right hand? If you're not sure, please don't raise your hand, because it's not playtime. Because you got to die, and I'm trying to help you get ready. So you raise your hand and say, if I died right now, I'm sure I'm saying. All right, every head is still bowed, every eye still closed. And some of you could not raise your hand. Some of you could not raise your hand. I don't want to embarrass you. I'm not here to embarrass anyone. God forbid that I do that at my dear sister's funeral. But I am here on God's business.
Amen.
And please help me. If you know you don't know God, and you know you're not ready, if you died right now, you know you're not ready, and you want to get ready, stand on your feet. Be bold enough to stand on your feet. Stand up. All over the place. Stand up. If you're ready, sit down. But if you're not ready, stand up. You want to get ready, stand up. Stand up. I said, I want to get ready. I see somebody standing in the family. Stand up. All over the buildings. I want to get ready to meet Jesus. Stand on your feet.
Amen.
All on the right side of me. Some of y'all know y'all have ladies. Stand on your feet. Stand on your feet. Oh, look at all the people. Look at all the people. Oh, come out here and say, oh, let them come. This is what this is all about to me. After all of the fanfare, after all of the singing and dancing, this is what this is about to me.
Amen.
Because it's a terrible thing when a man dies and go to hell. There's no exit in hell. You're burning there forever. You can't call Johnny Cochran or nobody else to get you out of there.
Amen.
You get in there, dear God, you're there forever. Am I right about it, somebody?
Amen.
All right, I want you to do one other thing. I want you to close your eyes while you're standing and raise both of your hands. Raise both of your hands. Anybody want to get in on this?
Amen.
Anybody want to get in on this? As a matter of fact, keep your hands up right now. All you in here who are saved already, but you know you're in a backslidden state, you get up to. First thing, I smell you in here too. Get on your feet. You know you're in here. Get on up. Stand up on your feet. You're just as vaccinated as you want. Vaccinated as a rooster, amen to God. Come on, stand on your feet. Get on your feet. I'm talking to you vaccinated. Get on your feet. Get on your feet. You know, you claim to be saved, your life is ragged. Get on your feet. I said, you claim to be fully saved, but your life is ragged. Get on your feet.
Amen.
You're fussing and doing all kind of junk. Get up.
Amen.
All right, now. Raise both your hands before God. And I want all you who are standing All of you are standing. I want you to say, Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
Say it like you mean. Say, Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
I know that I'm a sinner.
I know that I'm a sinner.
And when I get out of here.
And when I get out of here.
I want to get out of here alive.
I want to get out of here alive.
I don't want my soul burning in hell.
I don't want my soul burning in hell.
Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
I believe.
I believe.
Jesus Christ is the Son of God.
Jesus Christ is the Son of God.
I believe he died on the cross for my sins.
I believe he died on the cross for my sins.
I believe that he was buried.
I believe that he was buried.
And I believe he rose from the dead on the third day.
And I believe he rose from the dead on the third day.
I now repent.
I now repent.
Of all of my sins.
Of all of my sins.
I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry.
I cannot save myself.
I can't save myself.
But I know you can save me.
I
open my heart, Lord Jesus.
I open my heart, Lord Jesus.
And I receive Christ.
And I receive Christ.
The Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord Jesus Christ.
Into my heart.
Into my heart.
As my Savior.
As my Savior.
Save me, Jesus.
Save me, Jesus.
And make me the person
that you want me to be.
Now I want the rest of you to clap your hands and praise God. I told my wife on my casket, I want some slots put on there, and I want you to put a handful of tracks on these hands. And when they come through my body, I want everybody to take a handful and go out and soul for Christ. All right, now, if you don't have a church home, guess where you're standing in? This is your church home right up in here.
Amen.
Come back here. I want to see you. We want to see you here Sunday morning at 8 o'clock. Sunday morning, 11:30, you have a new church home. When you come in Sunday, you come on up and sign the membership card, and you're in one of the best churches in all of California. Praise God.
Amen.
Wonderful. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Mighty man of God. Thank God for him. Praise the Lord.
Thank you.
Now, there's another thing we need to do as we prepare to leave out.